Olga, can you give us a little light, please, Ruben? A little music? I'd like to call in for District 30, our dinner program for session, starting with Region 5 International Director, Distinguished Toastmaster, Magnus Jensen. Region 5 Advisor, Distinguished Toastmaster, Michelle Campbell. District 30s, District Director, Distinguished Toastmaster, Ivory Gwynn. Director of Program Quality and District Director, he left. Distinguished Toastmaster, Iqbal Acha. District 30s, Director of Club Growth and Director of Program Quality, elect. Distinguished Toastmaster, Tiffany Howard. And District 30s, Director of Club Growth, elect, Distinguished Toastmaster, Stella Lawrence. That brings us to District 30's Co-Director of Program Quality, and District 103's District Director, elect, Distinguished Toastmaster, Cassandra Lee. Next is District 30's Director of Club Growth and District 103's Director of Program Quality Elect, Distinguished Toastmaster, Bill Murrell. Director of Club Growth, elect, Donnelly Williams, Distinguished Toastmaster. And that takes us to our miracle worker this time.
Yes.
Our conference chair, the lovely Michaela Moe. Ladies and gentlemen, your District 30 Spring Conference 2017 at table. As we all know, the leadership journey never begins and ends with yourself. You need a lot of people to do so. And in the audience today, I actually have three very special people that I would like to take a moment and acknowledge. So the first and foremost is my mother, who is sitting in stages. First thing I want to do is thank you for being here, but I also also want to thank you for teaching me one very important quality, and that is respect.
All right.
In the many years that I have been your son, you have instilled a very strong sense of respect. And that I've carried that in every sense of the word, in every aspect of my life. So for you, thank you for teaching me what respect is. I would also like to thank my father, who's busy taking a picture of me. Dad, the quality that I would like to thank you for teaching me and instilling in me is a sense of excellence. Ever since I was a child, I have watched you embody what excellence means in every aspect of your life. And whether you know it or not, your son secretly was jealous of you for the longest time. And it is because of you that I try and embody excellence in every opportunity that I have in front of others. Third, like to thank and give some acknowledgement to my better half, probably my better three-fourths. That is my wife. So, Amy, I would like to thank you and acknowledge you for teaching me development. As your husband, over the years, you have really opened my eyes in terms of what it means to not just be better, but to strive for improving. And you have been probably the best mirror I have ever had. It's really important I tell you that, particularly in front of all these people, but in reality, you're probably the best suited person to check me on any time. And I really wanted to thank you. I specifically call on these three individuals, and I've attributed them three individual characteristics: respect, excellence, and development. And for those of you that were reading my brochures earlier, I talk about pride. And pride is really something that I'm trying to really reinvigorate in District 30, because I believe that there's five qualities that make us the best person possible. And those five qualities are professionalism, respect, integrity, development, and excellence. And three of those five come from that table right there.
All right.
I'm very excited to have the opportunity to work with Tiffany and Stella this year, and very excited to see what you will do as Toastmasters in 2017-2018. It is a journey for each and every single one of us. And as we stand here ready to embrace our new titles and our new positions, and the responsibilities, we understand one thing very clearly. We are not going to change the district. We are just three people that God voted in. It is what we want to do to help you change the district and improve yourselves. That is the goal. And I hope that by the end of the year, this will be the tagline that we will be using quite a bit. I hope each and every single one of us in District 30 will roar with pride. Thank you, and I would like to turn the microphone over to my new district director, elect for District 103, Ms. Cassandra Lee.
It was stated this morning that District 30 spawned District 54 back in the 1950s. Today, in the 2017, District 30 has yet again spawned another district, District 103.
You're here!
It is that district that I had the privilege of being the district director elect. And as someone just mentioned to me a moment ago, no matter what happens, you will always be the first district director of 103. Yet, I would not be in this position today if it wasn't for a few people that I would like to recognize and ask them to stand until I am done complimenting them. Let me first start with our current district director, Ivory Nguyen. Please stand. I can remember walking into the summer TLI 2009, and Ivory saw me walking in through the door, and he approached me. He said, "Hey, do you know you're close to getting a DTM? So when are you gonna get it?" And I said, well, I didn't really know, because at that time I wasn't keeping that close of an eye on my educational achievement. I was busy mentoring my club members to get theirs. Ivory challenged me right then and there. He said, "Let's get our DTMs together." He said, "I'm going to get mine, and you should get yours." And we did. He got his in the fall of 2009. I got mine in the spring of 2010. I would not be here today if it wasn't for Ivory Gwynn. Thank you, Ivory. I like to call them the tag team, because most times when you see them together, they're together. They served as district governors a year after each other, and I can recall the day when they tag teamed me to consider the position for district director, and I am speaking of none other than past district governor Joan Moore and past district governor Michelle Cable. Please. Ladies, I must thank you so much for having the confidence in my abilities to take on this new role. You saw something in me years ago, and you started to drop the seed and plant the encouragement for me to consider this opportunity. And although I told you no that day, you did not let up on the idea that I should still consider it. And eventually, I was able to see the light that you saw, and that's why I'm here today. I thank you for the encouragement. There are many times when you will hear people say a mentor helped to change their life, and they have many mentors who have inspired them, yet every so often you will hear the phrase that the mentor becomes a mentee. And it is to the gentleman that will become my right hand, that is right now standing to my left, that I would like for him to step forward, because if Bill Morrill, distinguished Toastmaster, my mentee, had not said to me, "Cash," which is my nickname, by the way, "Cash, I think you should consider running for the role, and I'm considering running as well, and we can do it together." Bill, thank you. It is such a privilege to have served with you this year with the quintet, and I look so forward to what we're going to do in the new year. Thank you so much for the encouragement. And my next to last thanks will go to members of the Wrightwood Ashburn Overcomers Toastmasters Club. Members, please stand. The members of WAO assisted me with the development that I needed to take in order to be prepared for this year, and that started 4 years ago. They gave me the opportunity to step outside of the club and not have so much of a hands-on role in the club, and gave me the chance to be a district leader and to start preparing to be your new district director. WAO members, please stand one more time. You sat down too fast. Thank you. I love you guys for your support, your encouragement, and your belief, and for giving me the opportunity today. And finally, for many of you who know my significant other, who could not be here tonight, who said to me on Easter Sunday when he was in his car accident, it was the fourth thing that he actually said to me, and that was, "Sorry I can't be at the conference to see you get your role, to see you get elected." He is here in spirit, and he would have been here with me physically if I did not say, "You cannot come to the conference because you just are not able to be here present. I want to make certain I give a shout out to Dushan Mosley for the support of the person.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. All right. Well, the group that just walked on will shortly be back in our eye this evening because it is time to formally induct them into their new roles. And to do that for us this evening, we have our district, our Region 5, me, our Region 5 International Director. Once again, let me call Magnus Jensen.
Thank you very much. Today we're witnessing a very historical moment. We're launching a new legacy. A new legacy of two separate districts that is spawned out of one, and we just heard that here today. So my role at this point in time is not to speak for another 45 minutes. That should be an applause. Thank you, yeah. Always one. Thank you. Fan clap back there. So we will do the district installation ceremony, and this time unscripted. I have text here. I will read it. I will read it. I will not divert too much from it. I promise. Maybe. There's always one. Fellow Toastmasters and guests. The district is the service arm of Toastmasters International. Our organization grows and is successful because of the hard work of our district leaders. These leaders are dedicated to making sure that every club is a distinguished club, every area is a distinguished area, and every division is a distinguished division. These volunteers are committed to ensuring that the district achieves the district mission and becomes a distinguished district. When a district strives to achieve the district mission and achieves distinguished districts, this means that more people are reaping the benefits of Toastmasters. First, would all of those serving as appointed or elected district officers for 2016-2017 please rise? Everyone. Any district officers. Remembering that your duties and responsibilities for the current Toastmasters year will continue until midnight of June 30. We offer you a special tribute and graceful recognition of all your hard work and contributions so far this year. And I applaud you all for that. I remind you to keep working for the accomplishment of all District 30 at this point in time. Goals until the end of your term. Please be seated. The mission of the district is to enhance the performance, extend the network of clubs, thereby offering greater numbers of people the opportunity to benefit from the Toastmasters educational program by focusing on the critical success factors as specified by the district educational and membership goals, ensuring that each club effectively fulfills its responsibilities to its members, providing effective training opportunities for club and district officers. Now comes the important part. Will the following Toastmasters please come forward as you are introduced? Stella Lawrence, Don Williams, to the incoming club growth directors, please come up on stage. Creating a new legacy, let's make it two separate district areas with a divide between. That's not a physical divide. You will all work together. This is just to show the new legacy. Tiffany Howard, Bill Morrill, Program Quality Directors for 2017, please come forward. Iqbal Atcha and Cassandra Lee, incoming district directors for 2017. Do we have a little separation between you guys there? So we can distinguish that it's a complete entity, two complete entities.
Do
you have a dividing line? It's not the Chicago River. Never mind. 294. Yeah, well, I just have to pick something. You know, that came to my mind there. Ivory was the river. Okay. Back to the script. Stella Lawrence, Don Williams. As club growth directors, under the guidance of your district director, you will be responsible for making the benefits of Toastmasters membership available to a greater number of people. You will plan, develop, and implement all district marketing programs, including building new clubs, club rescue efforts, club membership promotion, and membership retention. You also will promote high standards of service to the member and through the club. Will you accept these responsibilities? If so, answer, I will. I'll pin you as being official. Howard, Bill Morrill, as Program Quality Director under the guidance of your District Director, your primary responsibility will be to help every club and member reap the benefits of the Toastmasters Educational Program. You provide direction and counsel to division and area government directors and club officers on the educational opportunities in Toastmasters, and you organize and conduct successful district training programs and conferences. Will you accept these responsibilities? If so, answer, I will.
I will.
You will now be pinned. Cassandra Lee, as district director, you are responsible for achieving the mission of the district in a manner which motivates volunteer leaders and promotes a standard of excellence in all district activities. As the district chief executive officer, you direct the district in a way that fosters strong clubs, produces maximum growth in clubs, membership, and educational completion, and is consistent with the interest of the members of Toastmasters International. Will you commit to helping your district achieve the district mission, and will you help ensure that every club, area, and division is distinguished Will you strive to achieve the training, club building, membership growth, and additional goals, educational goals, so that at the end of the year, as a district officer, the district becomes a distinguished district? If so, answer, I will.
I will.
You will not be pinned. Selected your district officers for the next year. You have placed them in leadership positions. You have a responsibility to support them. The success of this district is the responsibility of each member. Will you be a part of the district team, and will you help the district team be successful? If so, answer, I will.
I will.
Louder.
I will.
Thank you. I applaud that. And ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the 2017-2018 District 30 and District 103 leadership team. An applause. Ceremonies, what's my next thing to do?
Back to
you.
Thank you, Magnus. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we have a wonderful meal waiting for you, and I think it's coming out the door right as we speak. So we'll let dinner begin, and about the time we get desserts, we'll recognize a very special class of our Toastmasters who have completed their educational program. So, get in the room and cue some dinner music. Let's take it. Attention as dessert is being rolled out. We have a couple more items on the agenda for this evening. I think it will still be an early evening for all of us, but as you enjoy your desserts, perhaps we can have your attention. You heard earlier this afternoon, about the amazing accomplishments by our conference chair having taken this up 45 days before tonight and really getting down to business 40 days before tonight. Last fall, we had a similar situation where our conference chair at the time had 60 days to put together the conference, and I'm guessing there was some kind of challenge that Michaela simply felt she had to meet. And she certainly did that in pulling this together in 40 days. So I know, as you do, how much our district leadership appreciates what Michaela did. But I also have to let you know, as a member of the committee here, that she stole our hearts with how well she ran the committee, how well she ran the meetings and pulled things together, how she would guide us, coach us, and make sure everything was accounted for in the time we have. So, Michaela, if you could come back up one last time, Stella has something we want to do. Michaela, thank you very much, and please accept these on behalf of the conference committee. Would you mind just taking a moment and telling the rest of us what does it take to put a conference in 3 days and 3 nights?
takes a lot of other people.
And I should really be giving every flower in here to the other conference committee chairs that are across the room. Patrick, who is in charge of emceeing and is brave enough to stand up here and do things that I would never do. Thank you. Stella, for being my mentor and for being the fall conference chair. Letting me help you. Wanda, for taking care of all the registration and the badges and staying up until 3 and 4 a.m. and all of her helpers too. And on the website too, we had so many people that helped out and did other things, and this really goes to all of you, and hopefully I'll distribute all the flowers to all of you later on tonight. I'll look out for the centerpieces. Oh my gosh, just everyone. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
It's family style.
Now we have an announcement that I think you'll find interesting for our district director elect, Iqbal Atcha. And director of program quality and activity and hour, and district director elect, Cassandra Lee.
So, ladies and gentlemen, as we've been talking about for months, that this is a very monumental occasion. That we have been saying yet again, millions of times, we are here to launch a new legacy.
Yes.
Part of launching a new legacy is to have something to remember it by. Wouldn't you agree?
Yes.
Well, for those of you that took the time, invested a little bit of your money into being here and enjoying the food, we wanted to make sure that you didn't leave this conference without something. And I'd like to give, we're all holding these lovely commemorative plates. Each and every single one of you that has a band, whether it's green or blue, will receive a commemorative plate with a picture of our logo. This is a beautiful commemorative plate. I'm looking at this probably like the first time, and I gotta say, I will give credit where credit is due. Tiffany Howard, thank you so much for helping us put this together. What? Yes, please give her a round of applause. So before you leave, please make sure that when you are walking out the door, one of us will be looking for your wristband, and we will make sure that we give you one of our commemorative plates. So thank you again, and I will turn the microphone over to our district director, Idrigo.
I would like to take the time to thank my team. It's been a long year of people. It's been a long year. And the support that these guys have given me will last a long time. We got to soak it in. This is the last time I'll be on the stage enjoying the moment. To see the sea of people at that conference was awesome. And I would like to thank Cassandra Lee and Iqbal Atcha for their efforts in putting this thing together.
Yes.
They were on the phone constantly. Them in my shoes. told. Every time I had this in my hand, somebody says, Iqbal, you better run. I'm going to pass him this baton. Because he is the next leader. Cassandra is the next leader. And the two districts, if you guys didn't notice it up here, they mirror each other. Male leader, female. Two females. Female leader. Males. Awesome. I was like, how can it be? This has been a weird conference. From the lectures to it. But I had a great time. Didn't we all have a great time?
Yeah.
It's just 30 has this problem, but we have a good time. We're like a family reunion or family picnic. But I want to thank Bill and Tiffany for helping me build clubs and just being there for me, setting me straight. This one down here, a little firecracker. I look forward to her being a PQ. No, I'm trying to say PQD, that's her new title. But it's PQD. And because she's got. Just her mind just rattled. Won't we do this? No. Won't we do this? Okay. And thank Bill has a lot. He has clubs popping up all over Chicago, ripping and running. I had opportunities to. I've never been experienced at the police department. I've never seen so many people packing heat in my life. That was an experience by itself. You do table topics, watch what you say. I seen that movie, it didn't work out well. But I just want to say thank you to you guys for a great year. It went so fast. It started out slow, but once we got going, it went fast. And I look forward to their leadership and these are really a lot of people don't believe in leadership. Toastmasters, and it shows in their careers. These guys, follow these guys, listen to them, they're your leaders. They're in charge of the district. It's not an easy task. You have to tell them. You cannot say,
well, this is Toastmasters.
No, what you do in Toastmasters, what you do in your job, and it shows. I want you guys to learn about leadership. That's why this is why I have this baton of leadership. I've learned about leadership. Being a district leader has helped me in my job right now because I always tell my boss, I'm here to serve you. My goal is to make you look good. And he keeps giving me projects after projects after projects. That's a good thing. As long as you're working, you will always have a job. If you're the boss is right-hand man. You will always have a job. So remember this. Communication is key, but understand leadership also. Thank you.
Thank you, Avery. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for taking on the helm of leadership for this district. Mr. Director, do we have anything else? Are we ready to round out the conference as we finish the group? That was it. Mr. District Director, thanks. Outside of our meal, I think we're ready to wrap. Let her finish our meal. Adjourn.
Well, I'll see most of you in the bar, but don't forget to get your plate. They're very beautiful. I have it in my china cabinet. When I got it, I stuck it right in there. It's a very beautiful plate. So just wait. Look at it. Show your wristband. This conference is adjourned.